Okay. I might be running a bit low on time with, but I'm gonna see how I can do. I'm gonna see if I can do another piglet run. I would offer an explanation, but I'll be doing this quick. Just if you need anything explained, I'll try and explain. But yeah, this is a game where I'm mostly focusing on Dream. That I pretty much mostly started speedrunning because of nostalgia. And you visit people's the people in the Hundred Acre World's dreams. And help them solve their problems and stuff. And I'm skipping all the cutscenes because the cutscenes are slow. As for why I'm collecting these cookies, they're currency, pretty much. Which you need to get stuff. I'll be explaining that later. And now,
Piglet thought the lollipop stick might be quite.
We use the lollipop stick to get Pooh out of the caramel, and then now he's out of the caramel. He's gone this way, so now we're heading back. And there's that cotton candy block in the way that we were gonna go, so now we talked out, we'll talk about a way to remove it. He said, get rid of the bottle, Piglet can't reach the bottle, so we tell Pooh to do it, even though we. Yeah, that's it so far. And then there's those autosaves, and L's gone now, I think. And now combat in this game. I'm getting hit twice on purpose by this thing. And I beat that thing to lower that. I think I'll just avoid that. Get that one.
Piglet had found...
You'll be hearing that a lot. Yeah. Yes, Piglet likes using itemizers. And now we use the candle to melt this chocolate door. And there's Rabbit, who just told us how to get some honey for Pooh. Now this Woozle is going to chase us around, but enemies in this game are very polite. They let you push around boxes while they just stand there. See? Wait, hold on. The A just stuck there. Oh, wow. And now the Woozle's gonna chase me around while I run after these cookies. But yeah, cookies pretty much let you get more powerful faces, like the... Blarg. I don't want to battle this Woozle because... battling takes a while.
Rabbit has just given Piglet a key.
And that key is to get some empty honey pots. To get an empty honey pot for Pooh. To pick up the honey now that the thing's away. The bees aren't gonna sting us. Specifically. But yeah, this is very much a game of running around the enemies. Speed-wise, anyway. And it would be, and I wouldn't be saving as this much, but... wouldn't have a memory card in and saving this much, but there's a part where... it keeps on... this part it might soft the game might soft-lock, and so I don't want to lose my progress.
And so, at last, Piglet had filled...
And... so I just got scared again. Getting scared when you're panicked like that actually warps you back to the starting area, which is a very good thing. Another reason why why I want to get scared, why I want to be in this state in most stages. Like, they're... two stages where it's going to be more trouble when it's than it's worth, but just because of the nature of them. And did that in... okay, did that in 9 minutes.
Shoot.
And now we're in Roo's dream, and we have to go get him for Kanga. Cutscene saying there are Heffalumps about. pretty much saying you need to beat these two to do stuff. And now, once again, I'm going to get scared. Okay, hopefully this will be the... Wait, it's a bit far. Well, you get to see the brave face I bought. Didn't want to show you that one, but... eh.
Piglet had just picked up a jar of glue.
I'm running a bit low on cookies. I'll see how I'm doing. Okay, that was... that I could afford to lose a little time on. And the reason I wasn't going to use my stronger brave face on these ones is because, yeah, you can just beat them with that face and... if it's quicker, why not? Okay, 101. I think that's alright. I think that's actually good. Net cookie thing, stuff. Okay, I'm heading back to this thing. Getting these two. ...123 going through. And now we get to play as Tigger!
And so Piglet found himself stuck behind the cardboard...
in which we can move a little faster by pressing A, by holding A,
would
to bounce.
The gate disappear. The only question
but Tigger...
now was...
okay, anyway. Yeah, Tigger's sections are kind of stealth-based, so... you can't bounce all the time, because it'll set off enemies to your presence, and, like here. So we're gonna wait for him to turn around, and then, yeah. Yes, Chrono Tigger. Actually, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna be here. That must be how I got the faster time. Dang it. Oh well. And luckily, activating cutscenes like that can get you to reset enemy positions, so...
oh!
That'll be good. I think. Guess I'll go with that. And yeah, I get myself scared back with that. 101 I'll deal- 101 I can deal with. And now we're back in here. Pretty much, Rue was locked in his room, and the key's somewhere around here. But all the cookies are in the way, so, which you couldn't get before, but now you can, and yeah. Okay, so I know where the last cookie source is. And I think this was a pretty good ruse room. I mean, I think this was a pretty good Kang, cookie getting section. Anyway, yeah, this cutscene. That cutscene plays whenever you get all the cookies in an area, which I usually don't want to play, but I have to play it to get this.
Ah, yes. Kanga has given a key.
And now I'm just gonna run for a bit to get back. Because this stage is probably one of the... this stage feels like one of the worst backtracking was. Like, it's just... Like, it's a long way and then there's nothing to do along the way. And now I'm in here, and Rue wants to get that ball, but and has a ladder, but it's missing a rung.
And a razor. Now, this would be useful, should there be any paper about. Thank you.
And one more cookie source. Which I'll... So, 169. That's good. I think. And now we death warp back. Or rather, scare warp, probably, is a better term. Fright warp sounds better. And now there are Heffalumps here, but we just run around them. And now we erase this rock with this paper rock with the eraser, because of course we do. And now we fight this Heffalump, which we're using our newest brave face on. And we're just getting rid of that Heffalump because it's been a bother to me before. Actually, come to think of it, I think I'd be usually one collecting these cookies. And now that's out of the way. There is this Beheflum. A new enemy, pretty much. Dang it, two faces. But yeah, that's why I was trying to do it with the... Like, depending on an enemy's strength, it'll take one, two, or three hits to beat, and then... One of your faces is like the equivalent of two hits, and then another is the equivalent of three.
Glue is exactly what Pig...
And now, we got a stick! Which we'll use as a rung for that ladder. And now that we collected that stick, there are more enemies here, because of course there are. But there are never enemies in this room, so yay.
Easy. Sorry.
And now pretty much what happened was, Vampire Woozle came out of nowhere, stole the ball, then made that door out of nowhere. And now we're gonna use our newest most face app. Hold on. And I'm... Wait, does it? Did it? Is it? Okay, reset. It's reset there before for whatever reason. I'm just gonna keep going. So now I have to go all the way back. But at least I won't be panicked this time. And you get to see these enemies then. And there's going to be an enemy rush, so I think I'll go quiet a bit just to make sure I'm concentrated for these ones, because they're... I just want to get through them quick. I just want to make sure I get through them quickly at this rate.
Yeah!
Okay, so those are hide and seek puzzles. If you try and get them while they're hiding their face, then they'll just they'll block your attempts to.
What?
And now we're in Owl's Dream. One of the dreams where I'm not going to be going into panic mode. Yep. Yeah. You jump. Yeah, it is like Psychonauts, except collecting cookies, except of. Well, actually, I haven't played Psychonauts, so I've heard things about it, but. Figments are like how you progress. Anyway, yeah, this is Pooh's section, which is the polar opposite of a stealth mission. In the way that it's, instead of none of the enemies know where you are, all of the enemies know where you are and you need to avoid them. Which is pretty much just like this, which is a strange bit like this speedrun already, so, yay. Yeah, I should play Psychonauts at some point from what I've heard about it. Okay, going the slower route. Yeah, Pooh does need to take over the like these bits to so you can get through. I mean, you could say the same about Tigger. I don't know, I feel like he gets a lot of the focus. But that's me. That's me and my Piglet and Rabbit enjoyment. Okay, I'll work with that. 147. Yeah. Okay, and I'm gonna go dark for this part.
Ah!
Okay, wow. Okay, yeah. It pretty much is Winnie the Pooh Dream Drop Distance, now that you mention it. But anyway, that was probably the worst time I've ever done that segment, but at least it's over now. And the reason why panic isn't so useful here. You heal every time, but you exit a dream.
Should you... One.
I will say one way that this isn't Winnie the Pooh Dream Drop Distance is that Piglet unfortunately has no Keyblade in this game. I mean, combat would be a lot faster if Piglet had a Keyblade. No, I'm wondering what it would be. And now I've been forced to imagine this. Whoops. Didn't want to do that. Piglet
had found a candle.
Yeah, Piglet does play. At least Piglet follows the rules of chess. Well, I mean... Actually, wait, was that a king? Huh, there is a Winnie the Pooh Keyblade. But the important question is whether Piglet uses it at any point. Oh! Raises drop rate of items. Nice. Okay, so... What we missed because we didn't watch the cutscenes... Okay, I'm getting pretty much no cookies this time, but... But yeah. Al lost his memory book, and he needs us to find some family portraits for... some reason, which he's not totally clear on, but... he needs them. So we should get them.
Small key. Now that's a very useful sort of thing to find.
Wait, wait, what am I doing? I need to push this. And it dropped one of the... Wait. Ugh. Okay, so that's one photo. Yeah, exactly. You got a small key. You can use it to unlock a door. But only in this dungeon. Well, not really a door, but we are gonna unlock something next. We got it to unlock that thing to get a map piece. And we're gonna use that map piece pretty soon.
Shoot.
And this is my favorite room in this this world. Because it's a lot more vibrant compared to the other stuff. New brave face, yay! That was the brave face that we got in Al's room. And we can defeat all these ones in one hit with it. Now we pick all those up and... That topples over so we can get across, but... Before we do that, we're gonna get some cookies. Okay, so this is a tree. I have no idea what this tree is doing here, pretty much. It's not mentioned in the guidebook, but it's not mentioned, like, all the other enemy types are mentioned in the, like, the game manual, but this one isn't. My two leading theories are, one thought of by me, that they are the wood that makes up the brave face doors, like those, the door that you had to scare to get through here.
This.
And Zeal's theory is that they're the tree, is that they cursed my last my Super Mario Sunshine run before I did my Piglet run. They're the source of the curse. Now for what we came for. You put the family portraits there, and there, and Secret passageway, yay! And mine, the secret passageway is a dark room, which Al is not willing to go into. So we will light these candles to get that carpet to roll out, because those are things that happen in dreams. And that was Al's dream. Now for a part where the game might softlock again.
Once Eeyore fell asleep.
Okay, we're good. Now I need to remember where the cookies are around here. Or I can just avoid them, because... And by the way, there's another tree here for some random reason. Those are the only two trees in this game. I do not know why these trees are here, but they exist. And we can... And I find it amusing that you can kick the door here when... Yeah. Like, kick the gate here when you... got cookies out of it the one way. I'll deal with that. And we push this pumpkin.
A rusty old key.
Oh, now that I think about it, this would be a pretty good... Could be used for? This... If you play this game, Mezzo, this might make a good night level.
Should... Although it was very heavy, Piglet managed to pick up the bell.
Anyway, here we're of the hide-and-seek variety. Oh, Owl's dream would... Yeah, fair enough. But yeah, I just suddenly realized that Owl's and Eeyore's dream... Yeah, but yeah, I just realized that Owl's and Eeyore's dreams would make good ones for night levels, in theory. Oh, wow, that's close. Closer than I wanted to be! Fair enough. Kingdom Hearts. The World That Never Was is a good one. Okay, so... I actually haven't gotten that far enough in Dreamed Out Distance to see the world that never was there. At least it was... Yeah, at least I'm getting this to this point. Another good thing about Panic, it lets you collect cookies quicker, and the cookies in this hallway are really annoying if you're not panicked. Oh, the cathedral. This particular hallway, or your whole dream? Because it'd be interesting if it wasn't just this area, but. Okay, that'll be my 1 hour, I think. And we're gonna be used to that new brave face because we've got enemies. That it's gonna be a pain if I don't take care of them soon. Pain later on if I don't take care of them here, probably at least. That cookie so graciously flew over there, so that's good for me. Okay, this was probably not efficient movement for this sliding puzzle, but eh, what are you gonna do? Thank you. Yeah, an interesting thing about the puzzles in Eeyore's Dream are, like, yeah, they're, like, if you saw there were three hallways you can go down, each puzzle in the one part, the part of one hallway opens up a door in a different part of the hall, in a different hallway. Like this one, like the puzzle that we did there opens up the path in this one, so now we're going to, now we're going down this route. And I'm taking care of this thing because it's annoying me. It's... I don't know if I need to, but... Are you... what? Well... at this point... at this point, this run may or may not be dead, but we'll see. Well, let me get these cookies at least. Okay, that's the one I wanted to get. And I am very glad that these Woozles are patient, because these enemies are all so patient, because yeah, I'd probably have lost. I'd probably have to redo this whole puzzle. Not for that. Okay, that should be good. Now let's see if I can make it out of here this time without getting scared by these heffalumps. Well, that was a fail. I've been able to do it before, but, Well, it does mean I don't have to go back in there. I'll get a few cookies in the next room to make up the difference. It's unusual to get out of. In this room, Piglet does amateur plumbing. By making that pop off.
Finally, Piglet managed to release the valve.
Okay, that'll hopefully be enough. Lining in here is so bad, I can't tell where I'm supposed to be going. Well, now, we finally get one of these colors that's gone out of yours life. I'll save that until after I... Yeah, this'll do. Until after I catch this thing. Why? There we go.
And so, Piglet managed to catch the feather.
Now it's pretty much just going to be chasing the colors down for the rest of the dream. That's the main bit. And avoiding these. God, I forget where that one was. So now I just run past this woozle.
What could Piglet do?
Okay, so message from there, don't bother with that mirror woozle, I can get it fine. And that's that one done. So now it's colorful again, but now it's also dark. We got visitors.
Shoot.
And I would scare warp myself back the one time I actually want to, but all the doors are shut so I can't. And now, here's where Rue comes in handy.
And so Rue very kindly gave his oil lamp to his good friend Piglet.
Oh, and yeah, this room's a lot nicer net looking now. And more colorful. And guess who's back? I'm gonna go dark for a bit to concentrate on this and then the upcoming enemies. But just to note, that is my favorite of the very brave faces. And those are and that was me beating all those tube half lumps. You didn't get to see it because I beat them so quickly, but if you give them enough time, then they just destroy your pet. then like that button combination, if you don't complete it quickly enough, then they make you then they let out a two-a blow and break your concentration. And you have to do it all over again. Now rabbit stream. Which is a lot more colorful than yours.
Piglet had found a shovel.
And I'm actually running a bit low on cookies, but I think I'll be fine based on where I was when I got to the end of Tigger Stream. If I get enough along the way, at least. All right. Whoopsie. Don't know why that time it worked when the other time didn't.
A sack of seeds.
Okay.
Shoot. No.
And yeah, I decided to do this kind of recently, but I am going to scare myself with that Woozle. Okay, now take your time. Oh. I always had a lot... When I first played this game, I always had a lot more trouble with that area than I should have. And that's the second Tigger part. Which I think is actually easier than the first one, now that I'm thinking about it. Actually gonna get payoff on that sack of seeds pretty soon.
A small key.
And now this is an annoying part. Thankfully, there's no time limit on this thing. You have to chase around like four of these cog parts. Okay, well that's one quick. We got. That's two. Good. Now let me get some cookies while I'm at it. Oh, that's one. Quick. Oh, wow, that was probably my best cog section.
So, Piglet retrieved the cog.
And I'm getting that brave face now because I feel like it. Just time and convenience. And now with that cog, we shall do this. And another time mission that's annoying if you're not panicked. Got that machine. And now we got another key. Rabbit likes his keys in the stream. Wait, did it? Well, at least it was after a good safe spot. Shame that happened there. It's never happened there on me before.
Shoot.
Granted, I'm gonna have to go get myself panicked again. No. Okay. Okay, I'm just not gonna worry about that. Or I could get it now that they're gone. I am gonna need it after all, probably. At this rate.
Piglet had found a crook.
Well, I'll go with that then. Thank you. 102. Okay. Now for more cookie hunting here. That's 116. Whoops. Okay, 120. We'll go with that. And that's that key. Yeah, I'll see. And now I'll scare warp back. But I think at this point I'm probably gonna be good on cookies. I'm still gonna try and collect as many as I can. I'm past the need to really go out of my way point. And now I scare warp back. Oh, wait, I didn't. I forgot to get something done. Blarg. I'll do something first, then I'll scare warp back. Yeah, I'm definitely good on cookies, I think. Just need 165 more. Right, actually 155 more. Oh wait, whoops. How'd I forget? But yeah, pretty much these logs that you push down open up those gates that Rabbit needs to get through. Oopsie. Now Rabbit's through. And that's Rabbit's dream.
Shoot.
That's probably a lot. Actually, one more chance. There we start Tigger's dream. And we'll be back here enough that I can go get more cookies. Okay, won't forget to get that.
Piglet had found a balloon at the carnival.
Whoops. Forgot to do the thing I need to do before I start getting those.
Piglet now had a full honey pot.
And I'm saving here to be sure about, because there's a place where it sometimes quit on me. I just want to be sure. There we go.
This honey pot.
186.
And now watch. Hold on. Watch this. It's like, no woozles? Woozle. It's there. It suddenly appeared. This is hilarious to me for some reason. I do not know why. Admittedly, Tigger's Dream's got a decent amount of backtracking, but it doesn't seem like too bad. Oh no. Well, there's one state, there's one part I don't really like doing, but I don't really know why I don't like doing it. All things considered. And there's our second to last brave face. Now I just need to get now when I get to 150, then I know I can stop with collecting stuff.
Ooh.
Piglet had found a seed for a large carrot. Yes, Rabbit was very happy, and to thank his dear friend, he gave Piglet a kettle of hot water.
And now here's Pooh again. This section's kinda annoying. We'll see, hopefully I won't have to redo it anymore. It's not this part, but it's this next part, specifically. Part of Tigger's Dream is an ice level. I'd say the overarching theme is a bit more of a seasons thing, but that'll be gotten into later. But yeah, this game does have an ice level too. This is about the part where the ice thaw. This is about the part where the ice thaws. And Pooh breaks the ice coming back because he couldn't have done that in the first place. I barely spend any time in this room. Oh, stream's been semi-laggy? It's fine, no worries.
And so Piglet rescued the whoopee flower seed that had been frozen in the ice.
Sorry if the stream's been laggy, I'll just say sorry. I'm just gonna get rid of this Ephalump because it's gonna be a bother otherwise. Rather bother on the way back more than on the way here. Two quick boozles to be. That was a pretty good button combination. Actually, might be a bit low on cookies. We'll see how many I can get. And now, time to push a block.
A magnetic magnet. How useful.
That'll hopefully be enough. Oh yeah, I just noticed fireflies around. I think they're fireflies. Well, I guess I'm going panic. This next little bit.
Brave little piglet succeeded in removing the dart.
All these heffalumps are a problem, really.
Piglet then picked up.
Okay. So I'm just going to try and pick up a few more of these from just around. Oh, too close. I think this is the one I want to get. First time, huh? First time Road Sweeper Heffalump's throwing me. But yeah, this is kind of a season thing because
Piglet picked up what appeared to be an autumn leaf symbol.
Oopsie, wrong one.
And Piglet found what seemed to be a sun symbol.
126. No, I don't want to cheer Piglet up. I like him scared. Guess I gotta run. What? Okay, that should be enough. Let's hope I can get something there. Well, I can get show you that. Well, I can get that one. Whoops.
So Piglet picked up what appeared to be a snowflake.
It does mean I can make you use of that to warp back here and then security save and...
Whoopsie. The iron gate was closed, but it did not have a lock.
Yeah, there's summer, autumn, and winter / ice level. Whoops, great.
Piglet had found a candle.
That's 150, I'm good. Okay. So I'm supposed to catch these Tigger stripes in a time limit, and then relight the candles if that doesn't. But that's annoying, and I don't want to do... And I don't know if I want to have to reset the candles every time and work on a time limit. Especially with how well I'm obviously doing already. Without time limit. With this time limit. So, I think I'll just leave for a bit. And look, lights are on, no time limit. Yay. Now it's just like that cog thing. That annoying, annoying cog thing. Okay, at least got one of them. Three more to go. Okay, that's all of them.
Yippee!
Well, too late now. And now Tigger's locked himself in the haunted house because he thinks that, because of stripes. Yes, because of stripes. And now we're good. And we have a brave face door again. We have to get one last brave face to be able to beat. And now I'm going to focus on this. And now for Sporty Woozles. Final normal kind enemy. If you're too slow, they change one of your button inputs. Like that. There's that one. And that is it for Tigger's Dream. Oh, back. Now just one final stage and then we're all good. Yeah? I'm almost done! But yeah, I'm just gonna be concentrating on this to try and beat it as quickly as I can because I'm...
Could that be Ruse, Paul?
I guess I'm gonna do soon.
My, my. An empty honey pot. Why, it's Owl's memory book. Piglet wondered.
So yeah, apologies if this last part's kind of boring or something, but it's kind of, it's mostly just... Watch, like, it's mostly just enemy battles. Welp, okay, and yeah, I'll just say this now. If that happens, then I have to do the whole stage over again.
And so... Could that be Ruse Ball? My, my, an empty honey pot. It's Owl's memory book.
And that was Owl forgetting how to fly.
Ah, yes, a paintbrush.
Well, I guess I have to do that over again for some reason. Because Piglet just glitched through. How did.
Shoot.
Okay, I'm just gonna focus.
Could that be Roo's ball? My, my. An empty honey pot.
Okay, see ya, Mezzo!
Why, it's out. The tree between the two islands was... Was this a carrot Piglet had found?
And the brush is still there. I would try and get two brushes, but I don't want to try. I don't want to see what would happen if I did that. And that is less than the normal enemies. Now for the final boss. That is the final boss, and that, now the final boss is gone, and time. Now you see the credits. I really gotta get going, so that's it for me. This is Corvus Agent. Until next time, this is Corvus Aatrox signing.